planning on going down to the lake to capture the Milky Way tonight. So I'm just out here doing a bit of location scouting. So basically I have three places that I'm choosing from. Each of them has its characteristics and pros and cons. So I thought I would go to each of the places now when it's daylight to see which will be best for setting up during the night. So this is one of the places I thought I would try out. I really like the rock formations here. Maybe I could use this as a foreground. And the Milky Way will rise here in the east. It's probably very slippery with ice on the rocks, so I don't want to have to do too much walking around in the middle of the night. I really recommend checking out the places you plan on using in the daytime, because when it's all dark outside, you really can't try out your compositions as easily as you can do it in the daytime. You have to take a lot of test shots, and they take a lot of time each, maybe 10, 20, 30 seconds each. So you lose a lot of valuable dark time or night time by not checking out your locations beforehand. So first place, probably not for nighttime photography. So I'll just head on to the next place, which luckily is very close. So this place I really like because there's a lot of places where you can access the water standing on these smoother rocks. We'll see if I will stick with this second place or if it's the third place that will be my goal for tonight. I can see that there's quite a bit more snow and ice here, so it's probably going to be very slippery. So this is the same place where I went for my aurora photography. So I'll just try to find a nice place here on the rocks where there is not too much ice, because I really don't want to slip and fall with my camera and my tripod here tonight. That could be expensive, if we put it that way. But there is some really nice patterns in the rock here, in the bedrock, combined with these smaller, should we call them pools of water. And these small pools of water make for a very nice foreground. So I'm not sure. It's always hard to decide which place to go for. But it's even worse when you're heading out in the middle of the night and haven't decided. So I'm thinking this could be the place for tonight. I plan to be out here by approximately 2 a.m. That will give me about 3 hours of really nice lighting conditions. Well, I'm just setting up for the first time lapse here. I'm not really sure where to put my two cameras. I had an idea to begin with, but I'm second guessing myself here now. I'm a bit worried that my first time lapse camera will get in the way of the photos I will take with the other camera. I'm trying to use these rocks here maybe as the foreground. And then I will have the Milky Way coming down there on the other side of the lake. As you can see, it's a lot of moisture in the air. Let's see if I can get my astro track set up. There we go. Let's mount this ball head on top of the astro track. Now I have my astro modified old 550D. And I thought I would use a 50mm lens on this one. I think a 50mm would give me a good field of view. It's a clear sky, but it's not crystal clear. There is some, I wouldn't call it fog, but it's some haze, I guess, due to moisture in the air. I thought I would try to catch some part of the Milky Way to see if I can do some stacking of those images later. I'm not sure how this is going to turn out because it's really, really high moisture out tonight. So let's see if we can bring in the other time-lapse camera, and I will take the really wide-angle lens from that one and use with this camera. There is some traffic passing by on the nearby road here, and they have really bright headlights, so I can see when they light up the sky here that it's really a lot of moisture in the air. I was afraid there was going to be so much moisture on the front lenses. There's a lot of frost and stuff, but I think we're fine. Well, as it seems, the clouds have started rolling in. It's getting way too cloudy now, so I thought I would just take the tripod with the astro track out here to see if I can make a combined landscape photo with a shot of the foreground without tracking and then some sky with tracking, and to see how that turns out. I really like this area here. The sun is slowly lighting up the horizon, so the time for astrophotography is pretty much over. I'm just trying to get some photos from the dawn here before I pack up and head home. Everything is really cold, really frosty now, so I'll have to make sure I dry everything out when I get home. Lots of frost. So now I just have to go back one more trip and pack up the rest of the gear. What's not to love about a beautiful morning like this? Unfortunately, I've got a full work day ahead of me on 3 hours of sleep, so we'll see how that goes, but I think I'll be fine with lots of coffee. So that's it for this time, and I hope you will subscribe and follow me for more of these photo trips, and feel free to leave a comment on what you would like me to cover, or if there are any specific topics you'd like to see.
my fingers are getting really cold, so it's going to be nice to get home and warm up a bit and make some coffee, get ready for a new day, new working day. So see you next time.